Don't act shocked that Mitch McConnell wants to fill a Supreme Court vacancy during an election year, even though he said that that shouldn't be done just 4 years ago. The passing of Ruth Bader Ginsburg has now changed the dynamic of the 2020 election. I have Farron Cousins here, editor of Trial Lawyer magazine, to talk about it. You know, the loss is huge. This is a jurist and a woman who has inspired so many women to move into the law. That's just the beginning.
Right.
That's just the beginning of Ginsburg. I mean, if you take a look at her rulings, it's in a lot of ways saved America. Give me your take on, is McConnell serious about this?
McConnell's dead serious about this. I mean, if he had his way, I think we would actually be talking about a nominee already today. Because McConnell, that's been his one and only goal for his personal legacy for many years now, and that is to pack the court. Supreme Court seats for McConnell are the bonus round. Mm. You know, he's gotten well over 100, well over 100 in just the last few years with Trump, and this is going to solidify that 6-3 majority on the Supreme Court. And honestly, it got to the point of being obnoxious this past weekend, watching people on social media tweet out at Mitch the finger wagging, saying, "No, you said you couldn't." If you've paid a bit of attention to politics for the last decade, you knew this would happen.
Yeah, it doesn't mean anything. Right. They don't understand McConnell's going to do this.
Right, you can't shame a guy with no shame.
You know, Pelosi can talk about impeaching and all this crazy talk. I don't even know, where does it come from? Where does the crazy talk come from, and how is it perpetuated? Is it somebody just says, "Hey, what if we do this?" And then the next person, "Hey, that sounds like a good idea," without any thought of understanding what's at stake here. This is a serious issue.
Right, and a lot of it does originate online, because people do understand, or some of them, the Senate can't do anything if they have articles of impeachment that they have to deliberate.
Right.
So that was the plan behind that. And Pelosi said, "Maybe I'll do it." And I think she was throwing some red meat to her base.
She's not going to do it.
Because that would be political suicide for the Democrats heading into the election, try to impeach a man. We know he's corrupt, but you don't really have an actual crime here to impeach him for at the moment. So that would absolutely energize Trump's base. So Pelosi cannot stop it, and I don't even think if she could, she would. We've seen that from her too much.
You see, what this is a rallying cry for conservatives. Mm-hmm. And later in the show, I'm going to talk to David Lamb, who's an expert on the polling, get his take on this. But, you know, instinctively, you say this is a rallying point. And then the more the Democrats do to call attention to that rallying point, the more serious it becomes for, I think, Democrats than it does Republicans, because it's all, I think, when you take a look at the numbers, it's who's going to turn out, who's the most excited about their candidate, who thinks is going to do the less damage. You know, it's kind of lesser of two evils kind of analysis here. So you have some folks that's saying they're going to maybe they're going to hold out. I don't believe it.
No.
You've got a 53 seat issue. They need 51. So if they lose two, that's the possibility. So you got Murkowski that's in the mix. You've got Collins. So you've got some folks that are saying, yeah, they're talking like they're going to do it, but I don't buy it.
Right.
I mean, I don't know about you, but I'm not buying Murkowski, for example, and I'm not buying Grassley. Grassley hasn't said anything. He kind of throws ideas out there. Grassley's not going to. Is not going to buck the system here, is he?
No, especially now that you have Mitt Romney, who says, "Yeah, I'll vote to confirm." You had Cory Gardner from Colorado, who says, "Yeah, I'll vote to confirm." They have their 51.
Right.
So, as disappointing as it is that we're going to have an appointee, and right now the name being floated is Amy Coney Barrett.
She's
terrifying.
No, you and I have done stories about her. We need to pick up on that story probably next week, to understand just how terrifying this woman is, maybe far worse than any of the males that they've put up there.
Right, she's a Catholic fundamentalist.
Yes.
And has some really...
Loves corporations, doesn't give a twit about consumers, so it's...
And it's saddening, obviously, to think that this is the woman who's going to replace Ruth Bader Ginsburg. But unfortunately, the reality that we all have to understand at the moment, we cannot stop this from happening.
Right.
I think the sooner a lot of people on the left get that in their heads, okay, focus we can't
on the
do it.
Focus on the election.
Yes, right. Yeah. We can energize and do something better.